Cool. All right, everybody. It's 2 o'clock on Friday, and we got a fun day for you. We're gonna be doing some parkour stuff, core stuff, some balancing, and we're gonna learn the round off, which is building off of our cartwheel. So the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna start with a light and easy warm up. So everybody, go ahead and stand on up. Make sure you got some space, and we're gonna go from head to toes, arms, legs, core, everything. Light warm up before we start hitting it hard. So first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna do some head rolls. So just go ahead and drop your head in front and start rotating neck around. And you might hear a little bit of crunching and cracking in there. Perfectly normal, as long as you're not swinging your head around like a mad. Okay, let's change directions. Nice. Nothing too crazy here. All right, go ahead and stop. Neutral head. We're going to stretch it over to one side. Reach your fingers down to the ground. Drop one ear to the shoulder. We're stretching out this top side of our neck here. Okay, now reach those fingers down. Good. Don't bring the shoulder up. Keep the shoulder down. Bring the ear to the shoulder. Okay, take a deep breath. Breathe out. And let's switch sides. Keep reaching down with the fingers. Good. Breathing in. Breathing out. Nice and easy. Good. All right, bring your head back to the middle. We're going to look up to the sky. Push your hips forward just a little bit. Lift your chin. Look at the sky. Keep your mouth closed. Lift the jaw. Good. Breathing in, breathing out. Okay, now we're going to drop the chin to the chest.
Stretching out the back of the neck.
Keep
pushing those fingertips down to the ground. Good. All right, lift the chin back up.
We're going to do some head to the side. Nose. No, absolutely not. Good, head's on a swivel. Nice. Good, nothing too crazy. You should still see things. It shouldn't look like a blur. Good. Now we're gonna hold our chin to one side. 3, 2, 1. Rotate our other side. Hold it for 3, 2, 1. Nicely done. Okay, now let's do our shoulders. Let's shrug them up and bring them down. Shrug them up. Bring them down. Who made this mess? I don't know. Up and down, up and down, up and down. Good. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, I'm going to go to the side. We're going to pull our shoulders back. Bring them forward. Back and forward. We're rotating the arms a little bit here. We can really spread the back open and open up the chest. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. All right, now arms are gonna go up. We're gonna do some big circles with the arm. Just let them swing around, big circles. Blades of glory, with our fingers slicing through the air. Good, let's do a few more rounds in this direction, and 3, 2, 1, we're gonna switch directions. Arms up and back now. Good. Nice. We're increasing the synovial fluid inside of our bodies to let all those bones slide around on the cartilage inside of our joints. Good. 3, 2, 1. Cool. All right, we're gonna do our elbows. Go ahead and make fists. Fists are out in front. We're gonna rotate. Warm up our elbows. Good, so go in one direction. And we'll go the other direction. Nicely done, everybody. Good job. Okay, 3, 2, 1. All right, our wrists. Let our wrists hang down. And we're gonna switch our wrists back and forth, left and right. Good, side to side with the wrist, side to side. Good. You can keep them up here if you want to.
Yeah. I don't want to be
together. All right, now we're going to pull our wrists up like we're pushing on the wall with our hands. Okay, straighten the arms, pull the fingertips back towards the face. Good. And now drop the hands. Reach the fingertips towards your armpits. Good. Good. Palms flat, fingers up. Good. And back down. Fingers reaching towards you. Okay, now we're gonna take our wrists like fists. We're gonna do really, really twisty wrist motions here. Okay, you're able to get a little bit better of a stretch there. Okay, now change directions. Okay, cool. Neck and arms are worm. Let's do the spine here. So go ahead and take a wide stance. And we're just gonna do some reaches over to one side. Reach the other side. 10 here. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. All right, keep your feet nice and wide. Maybe if you wanna work on your splits, you can take a wider stance. Now we're gonna twist left to the right. Good, if you can, get a little bit of extra stretch here in the hips. If you feel it, cool. If not, don't worry about it. We're just focusing on the spine. Nice. All right, cool. Bring your feet back together. And we're gonna put our hands on our hips. We're gonna try to do this while balancing. We're gonna kick our hips to one side, kick them back, kick them to the side, and forward. All right, so we're just gonna spin our hips around in a circle, pushing as far as we can the outside. A couple more twists right here. And then once we come back to the middle, we're gonna switch directions. So opposite way. Working on the balance here. Good job.
Common kitchen deck. Unsecured dishwasher door.
All right, cool. So now what we're going to do is we're going to warm up the knees. So take a little bend of the knees, put your hands on them, then we're going to move our knees back and forth in a circle. Big circle, big circle, one direction. Nice, good job. Okay, change directions. All right, we got a little bit of a hot mic there.
Do you
want to
do it on the
road? Yeah, I'm going to have to mute you. Okay. Legs together. And hold on 1 second. Still getting a little bit of bleed. All right, there we go. Okay, so now from here, legs together. Our heels are going to come up a lot like our frog jumps. And we're just going to push them forward, sit right on the heels. But our legs are together. Okay, so come on up. Squat down on the heels, a little bit of a bounce, come back up. Bounce on the toes, come back up. Good, one more. Boom, and back up. All right, go ahead and sit down. We're gonna warm up our ankles. And we're gonna start with toes up down, toes back. Toes away, toes close. And point, and flex. Point, flex, point, flex. Point and hold for 3, 2, 1, and flex for 3, 2, and 1. All right, now we're gonna go in and out with our toes. So go in, touch your toes, and out, touch your heels. In, toes, out, good. In, out, in, and out, in, out, in, and out. All right, good. Now we're gonna do circles with our ankles. All right, so go ahead and make big circles with your toes, drawing a big circle, two circles right next to each other on an imaginary piece of paper in the air. Good. A couple more rotations, and then we're gonna switch directions right here. Okay, good, rotating, bringing them through, around the outside. Nice. All right, cool, go ahead and stand up. Next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna work on our QMs. So go ahead and find your open area. We're gonna do 20 seconds of QM going forward. Go ahead and drop on down. Squat first, palms are flat, fingers are spread. You can start on your knees. Tuck your toes under your feet. Lift your knees. Here we go, 20 seconds. 20, 19, 18, 17, 16, 15, 14. Keep those hands spread. 13, 12, 11. Opposite hand and foot, move together. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. All right, go ahead, stand up, shake it out, catch your breath. Nice. All right, get ready. We're going to go backwards. All right, so 3, 2, 1, drop on down. Knees under the hips and tuck your toes. We're gonna go 20 seconds moving backwards right now. 20, 19, 18, 17, 16, 15, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10 more seconds, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Nice. Go ahead and stand up. Shake it out. Next, we've got our frog jumps. And the most important part about our frog jumps is that we are breathing as we move. All right? So go ahead and breathe in through your nose. Breathe out through your mouth. Now breathe in through your mouth. And out through your mouth. Okay, and start to feel as you breathe in, you lift up. As you breathe out, you collapse down. And that's how we're gonna jump with our breath, okay? So we're gonna start very soon. Let's take a deep breath in, deep breath out, and we're gonna go jump with an inhale. Ready, go. Inhale up and down. We got 10 of these. That was one. Up and down. Two. Breathe in, breathe out. Three, in and out. Four, in and out. Five, in, out. Six, in, out. Seven, in, out. Nine, no, it's eight. Two more. Nine, last one. All the way up and frog jumps. All right, stand up, shake that out, let the blood go into the legs. Okay, the next thing we're gonna do is some lunges. And we're gonna do an extra special challenging lunges today. We're gonna do jump lunges. So you can do the normal walking lunge as you go around. You can start with your feet in one spot and go back. Or with me, we're gonna try to do a jump lunge switch. So the advanced version is arms up. If your balance needs a little bit of help, you can have your arms out to the side. Let's see where my arms go. Not really sure yet, but I'm gonna try to keep them up. So this is what a jump lunge would look like. So we're in one position, we come up, and we switch. All right, so when you're ready, get those arms up. Okay, we're gonna do 10 of these. I'm gonna start with my right leg out. Drop down, jump, and switch. Good. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Nice. Good job. Really nice. All right. Next thing we're going to do, sideways monkey. All right. Notice as I squat, my hips come down and they sit on my heels. My heels are high off the ground. All right. We're gonna use 16 of these, back and forth. You can go one direction, you can go in a circle and switch when we hit 8, or you can go back and forth in your little area like I've got, okay? So go ahead, start on one side, get your ready position, and we're gonna reach across, hop the feet behind, Reach again. Good. That's two. Here we go. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Eight. Nine. And ten. Halfway. 11. 12. 13. 14. Keep breathing. 15. 16. 17. 18. 19 and 20. Nice. Stand on up. Shake your legs out. All right. Next, we've got our Kongs. We're going to do a little bit different type of Kong here. What we're going to do is we're going to Kong forward. We're going to walk our feet towards our hands, but we're going to keep our tail high up in the air. All right, so let me get a little closer to the camera so you can see. Okay, so I'm gonna squat down. I'm gonna reach out so my body's long. And now I'm gonna walk my feet all the way up to my hands. When I can't get them any closer, I'm gonna squat down. From here, I kick my legs straight back, drop the knees, and walk. I'm gonna go out, hips up as we go in, legs back, walk back. So here we go. Hands are going to hover over the ground. We're going to do 10 of these. Okay, so first one. Ready? Hands reach out. Land. Walk the feet. Hips stay high. We're on our toes. We can't get any farther. Squat down. Legs go back. Knees low. Walk it. All right. That was one. We have nine more. Hands out. Walk the feet. Squat down. Legs back. Walk the hands. Two. Hands out. Walk the feet. Bend at the waist. Squat down. Legs back. Knees low. Walk it back. Two. Here we go. Out. Walk the hands. Hips high. Down. Legs back. Three. Woo. All right. Here we go. Out. Walk the feet. Squat down. Legs back. Walk the hands. Good. You might start to notice you're getting a little bit more flexible as we walk our feet closer to our hands. Nice. Legs back. Walk the hands. Good. That's four. Hands out. Feet close. Squat down. Legs back. Knees low. Maybe we won't do 10. Arms up. Maybe we'll do 8. Walking the feet. Squat down. Good. Legs back. Walk it all the way to start. All right. I think that's five. Here we go. We got three more. Arms out. Walk the feet. Bend at the waist. Squat down. Legs back. Walk it to start. Okay, two more. Arms out. Walk the feet. Keep the legs straight. And then squat it down. Legs back. Knees low. Walk it. Last one. Here we go. Arms out. Pike walk. Feet to the hands. Squat down. Legs straight back. Knees low. And woo! Good job. All right. Go ahead and stand up. Shake it out a little bit. We're going to be doing our we're doing handstands, but we're going to be on our forearms. And so what do I mean with forearms? If you've got a wall behind you, this is gonna be pretty easy to get into. If you've got something like a chair or a couch, you'll be able to figure it out, but it's not gonna be exactly the same as if you had a wall. Okay, so first let's tuck in our shirts so they don't fall over our face. And let's mentally prepare ourselves for our handstand. So getting ready, figuring out what that's going to look like. Hands are down on the ground, okay? But this time, you're going to bring your hands closer together. Your elbows are going to be wide. You're going to drop your elbows and your forearms to the ground, okay? Now, we're going to walk our feet up the wall or our couch or our chair. We're going to be on our forearms. And what I want you to do is don't look at your hands. Look at where you have your feet. Okay? We're trying to push our chest towards the wall for our chair. Okay? So everybody's down on their forearms. We're going to walk our feet up and then push so we can't really see our arms. All right? So once everybody's up, we're going to sing our ABCs. Here we go. And A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, and Z. Now I know my ABCs. Next time, won't you sing with me? Walk your feet all the way down. Go ahead. Stand up slowly. Shake your arms out a little bit. It's time for some water. Okay, and I got a chat message. Let's go ahead and check that. All right, cool. All right, so the next thing we're gonna do is some precisions. So if you've got your precision blocks from the gym, go ahead and grab them. If not, don't worry about it. We just want to worry about landing comfortably and quietly. Number one thing when we land in parkour is we're not creating impact. We're reducing it as much as possible. So any impact is like when you hit a drum and you make a noise, all that resonance goes through the body. It takes energy to recover from that. So the less energy we expend, the more energy we're going to have, the more powerful we're going to be, and the longer we can train and play for it. Okay? So I'm just going to go ahead and do what I call a shadow jump. And a shadow jump is when you do something 100% with 100% comfort. Okay? We're not going for power. We're not going for distance. We just want to do it if we knew we had to, and we had to do it right now if we could. Okay? So when we do our jumps, our arms go back as we squat down. Our heels come up. And as we jump, we bring our arms forward to help throw us and carry us through the air. And then when we land, we're going to land right back on the balls of our feet and our toes. We're going to bend and absorb that impact. Okay, we don't want our heels to land. Our toes and our front of our feet should land first. Okay, so I'll show you an example. Arms are going to go back as I bend down. As I extend my legs, my arms come forward. And I land heels staying off the ground. Okay? So we're going to do 5 normal shadow, no real effort for our precisions, and then we're going to start maximizing our distance. Okay? So with me, go ahead and stand with your feet together, toes, heels, arches of your feet, everything's in line, knees. Okay? Let's bend, pick up the heels, arms come back, jump forward. Nice and easy landing. Let's turn around. Okay, and as you do this, let's keep those heels off the ground. Okay, stay on the balls of your feet. Bend down, arms back, jump forward, and land. Good. All right, again, we have 3 more. Arms back, knees bent, throw it forward, and land. Okay? And it's not a stick unless you're totally comfortable on the landing. You don't have to take an extra step. So this would be not a stick. That's not a stick. So totally stable right when you land. We got 2 more. Here we go. Knees bent, arms back. Forward. And land. Good. Bring it around. Arms back, knees bent, forward. And land. Good. Last one right here. Knees bent, heels up, arms back, throw it forward. And land. Okay, good job. Take a look at the distance that you were jumping and think to yourself, how much more power would I need to go a little bit farther and still stick the landing? Okay, and that's what we're gonna do right now. We're gonna do 6 more, do 1 extra, a little bit more power. So go ahead and stand maybe a step or two behind where you first started. And we're gonna squat down even lower, okay? So legs are still together, toes are touching, ankles are touching, maybe a little bit of space between, okay? Let's do six. Not quite max distance, but a little bit more intense. If you want to go max, go for it. If you start to slip or you fall, you don't stick it, it's going to take you some time to get back to us. Okay? So let's go ahead and start with one. We'll lower, bigger jump, and land. Good. Five more. Here we go. Squat down, big jump, and land. Okay? And you might notice that you need to squat even lower to absorb that impact because we're going farther, okay? We need to absorb more energy. All right, here we go. We got four more. Good. Nice. All right, three more. Arms back. Jump forward. And land. If you can squat all the way down, I want you to do it. Arms back. Land and stand. Good. Again, arms back. Jump forward. Land. And stand. Okay, we got two more, I think. Bend the legs, arms back, go forward. Oh, I didn't stick it. I could have jumped a little farther there. Okay, last one, here we go. Knees down, go forward. Oh, my heels landed. One last time for good luck. Make this your best one. All right, here we go. Arms back, jump, and stick. Nice job. All right, sip of water time. Grab some water. All right, next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna work on some rolls. Okay, so I like to practice a lot of different styles of rolls because you never know what direction you're gonna fall. Okay, it's very important to be adaptable to any direction because we don't know where danger always is. And we don't have the time to react. So we can react in our roll, we'll be a lot safer. Okay? So this move, go ahead and just watch. We're gonna start with our arms wide and our feet wide. And this is a little bit like when we go upside down, but we're gonna be going the other way underneath. Okay, so we're gonna bring one arm under. And as we start to get our forearm and our upper arm close, we're gonna curl and roll to that arm that's going under. Okay, I'll show you on the other side. The body is nice and wide. Okay, I'm gonna tuck the arm in. And as I can see, once I can see the ceiling, I know that I can unroll the rest of the way. All right, so we're gonna do this 10 times, five on each side. So go ahead and get ready. We're gonna take a nice wide base with our hands and our feet. Okay, so not quite like a push-up, but our feet are actually wider than the hands. All right, so now what we're gonna do is we're gonna pick up our right arm, slide it under, and as our shoulder tucks, we're gonna finish the roll. Okay, reset to the start, and let's do our other side. Arm comes underneath. Once our shoulder is on the ground, we can finish that roll. Okay, we got four more on each side. If you want to do it from your knees, you can go ahead and do it from your knees, but we want to add a little bit more strength practice into these rolls. So go ahead and get back up. Let's go to our other side and start from the original side. Arm under and roll. Good. Other arm, tuck it under, drop the shoulder, and roll. Good. Okay, we got three more on each side. Arm slides under, and we roll. Good. Other side. Arm reaches under. Slide that arm all the way into the body. Good. All right. Next one, first original side. Arm through and roll. Next side. Here we go. Up on all fours, arm under, and roll. Good. I think we've got two more on each side. Arms wide, feet wide, reach it under, and roll. Other side, arm under, slide the forearm along the ground, tuck the shoulder, and roll. Last one on each side. Here we go. wide base. Arm under, slide the forearm. Once you can see the ceiling, go ahead and roll. And last time, wide stance, arm under, look at the ceiling, and roll. Nice job, good job, you guys. Okay, next thing, it looks like we don't have time for our burpees, unfortunately. So we're just gonna move into our core stuff, and we're gonna be laying down on the ground. Okay, so let's lay down on our backs, and we're gonna be doing flutter kicks again, and arms should be at your side. Flutter kicks, it's like you're swimming in the water, okay? And imagine your arms aren't doing anything, your feet are doing all the work, okay? So a flutter kick looks like this, okay? You're swimming, okay? So we're gonna do this for 20 seconds, and then we'll move on to the next one. All right, so ready. Arms are down, you're flat on your back. Pick your legs up about a foot or two off the ground. Point your toes and let's flutter. 20, 19, 18, 17, 16, 15, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Drop the legs. Good job. All right. Now from here, we're going to roll over to our belly. And we're going to try to keep, we're going to get our arms all the way out straight, like Superman. Okay? And what we're going to do is we're going to lift our legs off the ground and our hands off the ground, and we're going to swim in place for 20 seconds. All right, so you should only be on your belly. Elbows, hands, and knees and feet come off the ground. And let's swim. 20, 19, 18, 17, 16, 15. Use those arms. 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Drop it flat. Roll back to your back. Now we're going to do scissor kicks. Okay? Your legs are like scissors. Your legs are going to go over and under each other. Okay? So go ahead and rest your body down for a second. Arms flat on the ground next to you, to your sides. And once we're ready in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Legs come up and we're scissoring the legs. Good. 20, 19, 18, 17, 16, 15, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Drop the legs down. Good. All right. Last thing we're going to do here on our backs is we're going to do some bicycles. All right. But I want you to, this time, you're going to bicycle your arms and your legs. Okay? Like you're falling down a hole and you're looking at the top of the hole and it's getting farther and farther and you just keep falling and falling. All right, so go ahead and get your body set up. You probably are already laying on your back. So, okay, we're gonna pick our arms up, pick our feet up, and for 20 seconds, let's bicycle our arms and our legs. Ah, falling off the cliff. Good. 16, 15, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Good job. I think I've got one more plan. Let's take at the clock. Take a look at the clock here. Oh. All right, we're moving on. Okay, next thing we're gonna work on is our balancing in a handstand. Okay, so for these, what we're gonna do is make sure that you're not gonna fall on anything, okay? So if you are gonna fall somewhere forward, you've got some carpet, you've got something to catch you, maybe a couch or the wall, but we're not gonna do too crazy of a handstand. What we're gonna do is we're gonna work on the legs, both legs coming up, and then the legs coming back down, okay? So we're gonna start with a split step. So I've got my right leg out in front, my left leg behind. My arms are gonna go up, okay? And I'm just gonna show you first what we're gonna do. So don't go ahead and do it yet, just watch, okay? So as I come down, my arms come down, my back leg comes up, and I'm gonna bring my other foot up to meet that back leg for a second, and then we're gonna come down in the same order that our legs went up. Very important that we think about what legs are doing which, okay? So I'm gonna go down, so my back leg comes up, my bottom leg comes up second, my bottom leg comes down first, then my back leg comes down second, okay? So we're gonna do this 10 on each side, okay? So our legs should be in the same position after we go up and then back down. So take a look at your legs. Remember which leg you've got down first and which leg you have behind, okay? So here we go, 10, starting right now. Here we go, up and down. 9 more, here we go. Up and down, good. 8, good. 7, 6, nice, 5, 4, good, keep that back leg straight, 3, 2, and 1, nicely done, good job, I didn't hear anybody fall, that's great, okay? Now we're gonna switch legs, okay? So I had my right leg in front last time. Right leg goes back, left leg in front, okay? We're focusing on this bottom leg. The bottom leg is gonna do all the work. It's pushing up, it's bringing everything up, and it's coming back down first. Okay, so we got 10. Arms are up. Here we go. Back leg kicks you up, push off the front. Back leg comes straight down. Good, 9 more. Good. 8. Nice. 7. Good. 6. 5. 4. 3 more. 2. Last one, here it is. And arms come up. Nice job, nice, nice, nice job. All right, so the next thing we're gonna do after we grab our water is we're gonna work on our round off. Okay, so a round off is like a cartwheel, except at the end, our feet down come down together. And a lot of people, when they start learning the cartwheel, they do a round off naturally, okay? And so a lot of times we have to fix that and get their legs to split as they come down. And we'll focus on the other one next. So I'll show you a cartwheel first, okay? So a cartwheel, as our legs go up, they're gonna come down one at a time, okay? So they go up one at a time, they come down one at a time. Okay, one and then the other. For a round off, both of our legs are gonna, they're gonna meet at the top and they're gonna come down together, okay? So I'll show you what that looks like. Legs are split. Legs come down right next to each other, okay? So we're gonna practice 5 on each side. And what's going to be important is where you're looking. So if I'm looking straight on and I initiate my cartwheel, as I finish my round off, I'm going to be looking the other way. Okay? So we're doing a 180 degree turn halfway here. Don't let it mess you up too much, but just think about if you're looking in one direction, you should be finishing looking the other direction. Okay? So you can pick whichever side you want to do, but most importantly, once your feet are up at the top, they come down together. Okay? So we're going to do five on each side. And go ahead and pick which side you're going to start with. Doesn't really matter. I'm going to be moving away from the camera, so as I finish, I should be seeing you. Okay? So go ahead and start with this split leg. Ready? Remember, that bottom leg is going to do all the pushing and generate that all the way up and over. Okay? So let's start. Here we go. Arms are up. One leg is back. Bend down. Kick it up and over. Both feet should land right where they started. Or like, no. I missed. Both feet should land together, not like they started. Okay, here we go. Let's go again. I'm going to go the other way. Come on down. Bring the legs up. Feet land together. Good. All right. Same side. Three more times. Here we go. Nice. Here we go. Two more. Nice. All right. Last one on this side. Here we go. Nice. Good job. All right. I want to see some of you guys try it out. Let me see you try it. Let me see you do it. I'm going to watch you, and then we're going to go on to the other side. Everybody show me one round off. Show me one round off. Oh, that's cute. Nice. Got somebody on the... Cool. All right. Next, we're going to switch sides. Opposite side now. I had my right leg back, and now I have my left leg back. Okay? Five on each side. Here we go. Arms are up. Lunge forward. Off the bottom leg. Both feet come down together. Good. Okay. Four more. Here we go. Lunge forward. Feet together. Arms come up. Good. Here we go again. Boom. Three more. Good. Really important you bring your arms up. Don't forget to bring your arms up with you. Good. We got two more. Good. One more. And up. Good. And as you practice these, you're probably going to feel like you can get a little bit more height in the air as you jump. So, nicely done. And it is time for a little bit of water. And then we're going to do our dance party. Okay, so the dance party, basically we're going to be bouncing and jumping a whole bunch. Okay? So as the music is going, you're just going to be bouncing on your feet. Okay, so let me see. You guys, this is pretty new stuff, but I promise if you just practice a little bit, you're gonna get a lot better. Okay, so here we go. We're gonna start the music. And your screen. Right. Okay, so everybody go ahead and stand up. Get ready. Come on, Manny, you can jump, you can dance too.
If you're alone and
I'm sweaty. All right, time for the cool down. Oh, wow. All right, go ahead and stand up. Stand back up. Go ahead. Stand in one spot. Feet nice and wide. Okay, arms are gonna be out. We're gonna do a cross the body stretch. Reach one arm over the other leg. Arm up in the air and just breathe here for four breaths. Good, inhale and exhale. Pull down on that foot. Good, inhale, exhale. Inhale and exhale. Last breath, here we go. Inhale, exhale. Breathe in, come on up. And let's go to our other side. Breathe out, breathe in. Breathe out, two. Breathe in, one. Breathe out, two. Good, we got two more breaths. Breathe in, and out. Last breath in here. In, and out. Let your whole body hang in the middle. Widen your feet a little bit more. Good. We're gonna breathe right here at the bottom. Breathing in, breathing out. Breathing in, breathing out. Last breath in here, breathe in, breathe out. And now breathe in and slowly bring your body up. Good, all right. Feet together, reach the arms all the way up. Bend one arm, drop the hand behind the back. Grab the elbow here, look up at the sky. Breathe in and breathe out. Breathe in. And out. Breathe in. Breathe out. Last one in here. Breathe in. Breathe out. Breathe in. Both arms up. And then switch arms. Breathe out. Good. Breathe in. Breathe out. Breathe in. And out. Breathe in. And out. Last breath in here. Breathe in. Out, release your arms. Good job. Okay, take one arm, bring it across the front, okay? And now you're gonna tuck that elbow into your other elbow, okay? Now try to bring your arm up towards your chin, okay? Breathe in, and out. Breathe in, and out. Last breath in here, in, and out. Release your arms, switch sides. Breathing in and out. Breathing in and out. One more breath in here and out. Release the arms. Okay, we're gonna interlace our fingers behind our back. Try to keep your palms together. And we're gonna straighten our arms and try to reach our fists to the ground. Look up to the sky. Good. Breathe in and out. In and out. In and out. All right, here we're going to bend at the waist. We're going to just bend over and let the arms hang over the head. Okay, we're looking through our legs, the wall behind us. Breathe in and out. In and out. Breathe in. And out. Last breath in here. Breathe in. And out. Let the hands come all the way down to the ground. Yeah, good. I want you to bend your knees a little bit and grab your big toes with the first two fingers of each hand. Not the thumb, but the index in the middle. And from right here, we're going to try to straighten our legs. Breathing in. Then breathing out. Can't straighten the legs. Grab the ankles. Maybe you can straighten your ankles there, your legs there. Wherever you can, I want you to straighten your legs. Good. Breathing in. Breathing out. Breathing in. And breathing out. All right, so bend your knees. Sit all the way down. Hands on the ground. Tail on the ground. Good. Okay. Both legs straight out in front. Take one leg. Fold it over the other. Foot flat on the ground for the bent leg. Pull the knee into the chest, and we're gonna rock back and lay on our back for a second. for a few seconds. Okay, good. Breathing in and out. Breathing in and out. Two more breaths. Breathing in and out. Again in and out. All right, you're gonna have to rock yourself back up to the seat. Switch legs. Other leg up and over. Pull the knee into the chest. Good. All right, we're gonna roll back, flat on our back, pulling the knee into our chest. The other leg is dangling over the ground. Breathing in and out. Breathing in and out. Breathing in and out. Last breath in here, breathing in and out. Keep your back on the ground, release your legs. Let them lie down flat. Good. Take your arms, reach them over your head. Reach above your head to the wall behind you. Good. Okay? Breathe here. Reach and breathe. Inhale and exhale. Inhale and exhale. Good. One more breath in here. Inhale. Exhale. As you breathe out, tuck your knees up into your chest. Grab your knees. Grab your shins. And rock up to our feet. Go ahead and stand up. And once again, the end of our class. But what I want you to do, last time, we said, wanted you to go and ask your parents how you can help with something. Okay? And today, you're going to do that twice. Okay? You're going to go say, hey, how can I help? Or what would you like me to do? Or what do you need me to do today? Okay? We're strong so we can be useful. Okay? And at this moment, before we go, we're going to also think of one thing that we're grateful for. Maybe it's our cooking at home. Maybe it's all the activities that our parents have been providing for us. Maybe it's the fact that we are at home and safe. And we're being good. We're being healthy. So go ahead and wave goodbye. And go tell your parents you love them and tell them you want to help them out. All right? See you later, everybody. Good job today.